As well as using the filter pane to filter down the data that you're showing in your report pages, you can add an on-canvas filter that we call slicers. Now, these are visual cues that your users can use to interact and filter down the data that they're looking at dynamically. We've got a range of different ways of formatting those slicers to help, depending on the data and the layout and the format of your report. Let's have a look at some of those different options. So I've got a report here with a few different visuals in it, but I want to use the space over on the left-hand side here to give my users a way of interacting with this and very easily filtering down the data. So I'm going to start off by letting people choose to filter down based on the product category. I'm going to add that to my chart, and you'll see it create a table by default, as we'd expect. But I can convert this into a slicer. This is a different type of visualization. And now this is, by default, this is just showing the same list, but I can use this by clicking on these. I can choose to filter down all of the other visuals in my chart, report to show those different categories one at a time. So it's a really easy way to kind of swap between them and compare. For example, you can see the change in the shape of the trend over time across these different categories. So the rural categories had this real big uptick in recent months. Everything else has been fairly flat over the end of the last few months. So I can click on these, and you'll see by default as I click, it's changing what's selected from one category to the other. But I can also combine these things together by holding down Control and clicking again, and you can see now I've multi-selected rural and urban. Again, just clicking off that and clicking one at a time goes back to selecting a single value. If I click on the value that's already been selected, it actually clears that filter, and now I'm looking at all of the data again. So that's a simple kind of list slicer where I'm just using the default options. But we've got a few different ways of formatting this. So I've got all of the typical sort of color formatting and background formatting that you would expect, but I can also change how the selection model works in this slicer. So by default, you'll see the single select mode is turned on. If I turn that off, now you'll see this acts more like a checkbox. So one click at a time, I'm not holding down Control here, but it's adding to this selection. This is possibly more like filters that you might be used to in Excel, where extra clicks add to the selection rather than replacing it. And I can also click on it again to then remove items from my selection. Again, clicking on the last one is going to clear that filter and reset it back so I can see all of the data. I can also choose to turn on the select all option. Now, this actually has some extra use so that A, I can click to select all, and now I'm kind of applying, show me all of this data. But now if I start removing these, you'll see that the select all option has a slightly different icon. And this represents that I'm doing a negative filter here. So I'm actually saying, show me all of the categories apart from mix and rural. Now that's different to saying, just show me urban and youth, because if I refresh this data and suddenly a new category appears, in this mode, it wouldn't be selected. So it's more like a negative filter. So it's everything apart from mix and rural rather than just showing me particular ones that I'm interested in. And again, this kind of matches some of the functionality that you'd see in Excel filters. So it's important to just understand that distinction. So I can turn on select all and give my users a little bit more flexibility in the way that they use these slicers to choose their values. I can also turn on search within this. So if I had a very long list, not such a problem here when I've only got four categories to select from, but I can turn on a search box, and this allows me to type in the value that I'm looking for and then just select from that. So the selection model is just the same that, you know, a single click would add to the selection here, or I can control click if I was in the single select mode, but it's just filtering down what I'm looking at in the slicer so I can find values more easily. That's something that any user can turn on, even if they're just consuming this, they can turn that on by hitting that dot, dot, dot menu and search through their values. I could also change from this list where I'm showing all of the different categories to a drop-down slicer. And this is very useful, particularly if you've got very long lists and not much space in your report. So now you can see I've got a drop-down that gives me all those categories to choose from. So again, I can choose which ones I want to select. I've got multiple selected. It will show me that in the restatement, or it will just show me the name of the category. And if you think about, you know, how you might build this report with lots of different visuals in it, I can use more space for the visuals and reduce the amount of space that I need for these slices, these filters. Keep that over here for now. Now, of course, I can add more of these slices if I want to. So let's drag another one in here for our category as well. Sorry, category we've already got for our segment as well. I might do the same thing. So I've got a drop down here. So defaults to all. And I might add another one for something like our year. Add this in here too. Turn that into a slicer. And let's leave this one as a list because it's only got two values in it. So I can build up a set of filters that my users can choose from to slice and dice their reports in a different way. There's one more formatting option that I can apply here. And actually, let's use this year slicer to do that. Under the general section, you'll find an orientation option as well. So as well as this kind of vertical list, I can use a horizontal list. And this gives me a way of sort of adding tabs almost to my report. So I can choose from 2014 or 2015. The different values here. And again, this is something that I see a lot of people will use across the top of their reports to kind of show different tabs in their reports, visualize it in a slightly different way. There's a whole range of different ways that you can use these slicers, these on-canvas filters, to help your users find a nice, easy way to slice and dice and get to exactly the data they're interested in.